What's up, guys? Jake here with a new attack strategy that I've been using. I was sort of turned on to this by some of the viewers, some of my kingdom mates, things like that, and it is a game changer. Now, the one thing is it does take paladins. So you get that at Stronghold 7. Let's look at them here. One thing I want to point out are this. One, obviously, that they heal. Nearby allies gain passive health regeneration. This can stack up to 5 times from different paladins. Okay, so the more paladins we get, the more powerful this attack is going to get. But even more than that, look at what it's got here. Health 200, damage per second 18.75. And this is level 1 paladins. Now, you can upgrade them at Stronghold 7, but still, it's not the point. What I want to point out is this. Maulers, health 200, damage per second 24. So for just a little bit less hit points and a little bit less DPS, you are getting the healing. So definitely these are better than the Maulers. Put them out front and put some Wardens behind it. You see the setup I've got there is 2 and 2. Now the ancient I'm using on this is Foreveil, for it. How am I going to say that thing? The dragon, Foreveil is what I call it. Let's go to it. I actually saved a few attacks on the very end of this Kingdom War that we have going on right now, just to show you guys this how I'm using it with that particular ancient and having some pretty good success with it. So we got 3 attacks we'll do. We'll get it started here. The last 3 of theirs. And again, it's just the real power of this comes at because of the of this first ability of Foreveil, the Frost Shield. You're reducing 50% of the damage taken and immunity to spell towers equipped with the freeze. So they can't freeze them. But for almost 10 seconds, you're cutting the damage coming in half. Now, what that essentially does is nullifies catapults. So even if they're hitting them, it's only doing half damage plus the regeneration from the paladins. They're almost a non-issue. So what we'll do here on this one is we'll show you what I'm talking about. I will go ahead and grab this. Well, actually, there's not much free mana, so let's just go for it. We'll just drop them together. And you want to keep your group of troops together on this one, strangely enough, because you see how it just keeps everybody healed up, the splash damage coming in, but no big deal. As soon as we get that first ability right there, we're going to go ahead and put it on everybody. Now everyone's taking half damage. Actually, I missed the paladins out front, but that's okay. My dragon got out there and did a little tanking I didn't want him to do. But you see that everybody's just sort of staying healed up. We'll drop another one there. They're going to work their way through. You know, no hurry here. The second ability is pretty good. You get like an ice elemental to go in, and that does a lot of damage as well. But obviously, I don't know if you guys have done this ancient, but the third ability just freezes everything. So that's overpowered as well when you have a healing troop like we do, because it just gives them time to just stop everything. We'll use it right here. Boom. Just freezes everything. Now everything gets a moment just to stop and heal up. So pretty awesome. We'll go ahead and drop an ice elemental so you can see those guys there because they're pretty powerful. But absolutely just crushed that base. Just walked right through it. So this is how I am using it and how I'm having success with it. So let's do a couple more and then we'll just wrap this up. It's going to be a short video. Sorry, I had to get a drink of beer. I had to drink some beer because, man, my attacks in one hive and Clash of Clans have just been awful. I'm in the middle of a slump. I mean, it's official. It's not good, so I'm going to have a few beers. Much tighter base. Let's see where we want to come from here. Let's just come where we're going to get a lot of this mana. Again, we'll just get these guys. Actually, you know what? Let's come from the top here. That way we stay away from those Skywatchers a little bit with our dragon here. We'll go ahead and drop him on the top. Let him start helping out. Again, you see how that just everything's, especially when they're bunched up like that, I mean, everything just stays full health. Nothing really gets hurt. We'll go ahead and drop the shield on them as the splash damage starts coming in, but you see how little that's actually doing that splash damage there. We'll drop it again just to keep it going. Probably a little quick on the second one there, but no big deal. Right there, the stronghold's almost already down. As soon as it goes down, we'll just freeze everything for the fun of it. I'll do that. Then we'll fly this dragon through here just to keep him away from those Skywatchers. Go ahead and give another shield to our guys. But I think you guys get the point. I mean, just absolutely running through this base. I don't know that I've lost hardly anything, really. With that shield on them, they just are almost, and the heals coming in, they're just almost unstoppable. We'll just fast forward it because this one's over. All right, one more to go, the king, and we'll be done. I just want, again, wanted to show you guys what I'm using after I sort of surpassed what Nyrax. Actually, I got four attacks. Sorry, I thought I had three. After what Nyrax is I've outgrown him. You get into a little bit harder bases, and he's not quite as effective. And better base designs when people stop leaving those troop portals out there to get that free mana. It just is not as effective. So let's just come into the top here and get this wad of, you know, boosted buildings taken care of. Get them out of the way. We'll fly our dragon up here in just a moment to help out. We'll also, as soon as they start getting in range, go ahead and drop those. Give them some shields. I'd miss those guys on the left there. Let's see. Let's fly my dragon up here. Right there. Freeze everything for a moment. We'll go ahead and use that ice elemental. Get him right in there in the middle. Let him do some tanking and take out that that boost there. Right there. Everything's looking pretty good. We'll drop another shield. There's just almost, I mean, this hasn't been a pretty sloppy attack, but there's just almost no way you can mess it up because that splash damage just ain't going to take them out. It just ain't going to get the job done. Let's see. Stronghold's locked on. We'll drop that shield on them again. The paladins, when it hurts you is when the paladins separate from your wardens. That's when you can start getting taken down. But right here, boom, it goes down. And we'll go ahead and freeze everything. Just let them grab what's left. They sort of bunch back up, so that was good. Drop a shield on them. See what they decide to do here. See how they get back in range and they start healing up again. It's a pretty wide range, too, that they can sort of get heals from. So, but just those two paladins and those two wardens right there took out the rest of that base. I mean, it's a powerful combination. We got one more, I think, the king attacking, and we'll be done. All right, here we go. See if we take this king out. And this is going to be the end of the league war that we have going. After this, we will be in Axe League, so that's pretty exciting. We'll just move our way right up. Yeah, let's get these guys in here. Boom, 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 boom. All right. Give them a shield. Everybody standing together. That's perfect. What's going on here? Here we go. Wouldn't zoom in for me. As soon as that runs out, we'll give them another one. But you can see, I don't know that we've lost anything really yet. Those paladins are tanky, especially when you give them half damage. Right there, this is already over. We just need them to lock on to the stronghold, which they're doing. Boom, it's going to go down. We'll freeze everything. And then just fast forward, because this one's all over. All right, guys, that is it. Hope you try the new attack out. And it's something that, you know, you don't have to have like a special ancient. Everyone that does the single player campaign, which is very easy, can get this ancient. And then all you have to do, again, is get Stronghold 7, upgrade your barracks to get your paladins unlocked, because they are a game changer. Hope it helped. Until next time, Jake reminding you guys to suck less.